I stand here today, colleagues, as the Vice Chair of the Legislative Black Caucus and presenting Senate Resolution 70, recognizing not only Black History Month, which is truly American History Month here in the California State Senate, but also honoring the life of Frederick Madison Roberts, the first American of African descent to be elected to the California Legislature in 1918. This marks the 100th anniversary of that historic election. Mr. Roberts was born in Colorado, but at the age of six, his family moved to California to Los Angeles, where his father opened up the first African-American-owned mortuary on Los Angeles Street, 12th on Los Angeles Street, to be exact. If you were to go down Los Angeles Street today, you know it's the heart of the Garment District. He attended LA High School, where he was the first American of African descent to graduate from LA High School. He went on to attend USC, where he majored in pre-law, only to transfer to Colorado University, where he played football and graduated there. He also attended embalming and mortuary school while in Colorado to come back and run his father's business. He was an editor. He was the owner of a newspaper. He was a president of a university. He was also a deputy assessor of El Paso County in the state of Colorado. In 1918, Mr. Roberts decided to run for the state assembly. I venture to say it was a vicious, nasty campaign. He ran as a Republican, and one of his opponent's literature simply stated, "My opponent is a nigger." And it was a nasty campaign, but he persevered. He won. Not only did he win, he went on to serve for 16 years in the state assembly, and was affectionately known as the Dean of the Assembly because of his intellect, his collegiality, and his sartorial presence on the floor at all times. He was a true Renaissance man. It's often stated that Willie Brown is the best dressed man to ever grace these floors. I venture to say Mr. Roberts would have given him a run for his money. Mr. Roberts also went on to author groundbreaking legislation in 1919, integrating restaurants, housing here in the state of California, other civil rights laws, and also introduced an anti-lynching law. Yes, California did lynch people of color. He was progressive, well ahead of his time. Again, served for 16 years, and in 1934, he was defeated by another man of color of African descent, that of Augustus Hawkins, who was a Democrat. And so ironic, Augustus Hawkins went on to be the first African American to serve in the California legislature from California. So today we honor the works of Frederick Madison Roberts, and Mr. Roberts also holds another distinct honor. He is the only individual in both houses to be a direct descendant of a U.S. president. Yes, Thomas Jefferson is his great-grandfather, a piece of history that we choose to bury and ignore, but he is a direct descendant of Thomas Jefferson, and again, the only individual in the history of California to bear that distinction. So I'm honored here to recognize the contributions of Frederick Madison Roberts, his life not only as a legislator, but as a newspaper publisher, a businessman, and a great Californian, a great American. And I ask you in joining me in casting an aye vote on SR 70.